Welcome to VDrum Tips. The Roland TD20 is a flagship electronic drum module that was produced from 2004 until 2012. Like many other older Roland modules, it is still a great option for certain e-drummers. In this video, I will tell you exactly why. There are actually three versions of this module: the plain TD20, the expanded TDW20, and the TD20X. The plain TD20 was made from 2004 until 2008. It was very similar to the Roland TD12 in terms of trigger capabilities and sounds. The higher triggering was not great in combination with the Roland VH12, but very good with the Roland VH11. The sounds were a bit plastic-like, similar to the Roland TD12. Roland released the TD20X module in 2008, which had a dark grey metal casing and additional functionality, like advanced triggering and more sound editing features. In the very same year, Roland released an expansion card for the plain TD20, in order to keep the owners up to date. The TDW20 is a physical update card that raises the TD20 to the level of the TD20X in terms of sounds and functionality. In short, the old TD20 plus TDW20 expansion is equal to the TD20X. But more about the TDW expansion card later. The Roland TD20 is a flagship module with 14 trigger inputs. All of them are stereo inputs for dual zone trigger pads. It is compatible with the Roland VH11 and 12 hi-hat. Both of them count as the top electronic drum hi-hats on the market. The TD20 supports all kind of Roland and ATV 3 zone ride cymbals, and it has the closed hi-hat foot pressure feature, where the hi-hat pitch changes when you increase the foot pressure of the closed hi-hat. The module comes with the Roland positional sensing feature on snare and ride. It recognizes where you hit the snare pad and is adjusting the sound accordingly. It has advanced trigger editing parameters, such as different trigger banks and side stick adjustment. Those help to fine-tune the triggering. It comes with a MIDI input to trigger 8 internal percussion sets, meaning you can expand the module with a second slave module to connect even more trigger pads. It has advanced sound editing features. You can adjust the mic distance, head type, muffling, shell depth, and much more. It comes with 8 analog sliders to quickly adjust the instrument volume. The 8 individual audio outputs make this device a great live module. It has a foot switch input to control functions like closing the hi-hat or changing the drum kit. The TD20 has a compact flashcard slot for backing up drum kits and settings. Another nice detail is the input volume knob, a very handy feature if you jam around to music from your connected phone or MP3 player. Like mentioned before, the old TD20 can be upgraded with the TDW20 expansion board. This board came in a physical box and included a circuit board, a flash card, a set of stickers, and a user manual. It is not in production anymore. This upgrade added 300 new instruments, new ambience types, 50 new kits, new functions like kit copy, mixing groups, and so on. Additional instrument editing features like snare bus, new mic positions, kit resonance, and more. It also added enhanced trigger response, smoother sound control on the hi-hat, which is the main reason for this upgrade, as the VH12 triggering becomes incredibly good, while it is not great without the upgrade. Please find more information about the improvements linked in the video description. Those improvements from the expansion card explain the difference between TD20 and TD20X2. The update is simple. You need a screwdriver to open the bottom plate of the TD20, insert the card, and close the case. After that, you insert a compact flash card and proceed the upgrade process. The expansion card came with a set of stickers that should be attached to the module, but don't trust these stickers only. Turn on the module and check if it shows TDW20 before you buy one. Both plain TD20 and TDW20/TD20X received another update that added a few more trigger settings and minor improvements to the module. It can be downloaded for free from the Roland website. Find the link in the video description. The differences between the plain TD20 and TD20X are basically the features added by the expansion board. In short, a TD20 with expansion board is equal to the TD20X, with the difference that the TD20X is newer. The plain TD20 module costs around $600 to $800. It is cheaper due to its age and the missing expansion card functions. The expansion board can rarely be found on the second-hand market, since it is not in production anymore. People sometimes sell them for a very high price, so I'd rather buy an expanded TD20 or a TD20X straight away. If you have the choice, try to buy the TD20X rather than the TDW20, as you can't be sure that the TD20X is newer and lives longer, especially regarding the LCD screen and the backup battery issue that can arise. More about those issues later. The plain TD20 is good enough for VH11 owners, users that want to have a module with many inputs and the option to expand it with a slave module, and the ones that need positional sensing to trigger a high-end VST. In this case, you won't need the expanded TD20, nor the TD20X, but if you want to have all instrument editing features, much better drum zones and a well-triggering VH12, you should definitely go for the expanded version. Especially live drummers should only go for the expanded version due to the sounds. The TD12 is basically a reduced version of the plain TD20. Both work great with the VH11 hired, but not so good with the VH12. The TD20 has 3 more trigger inputs, more volume sliders, more audio outputs, and other advanced features. Other than that, they are very similar in terms of sound and triggering. Both come with positional sensing on snare and ride. However, in some cases the TD12 is already a good enough module. It can be expanded with a slave module too, so only the inputs are not the best reason to upgrade from TD12 to a plain TD20. Instead of buying a TD20 for more triggers, you can simply connect a TMC6 to your TD12 to have more pad inputs. As a VST user, you will be good with a TD12, as most features like volume sliders and additional outputs do not matter to you. The significant differences are the audio outputs, trigger inputs, and instrument volume sliders. The rest is more or less identical. It is a different story when comparing the TDW20 and TD20X with the TD12. The advantages are the same as mentioned before when comparing the plain TD20 with the expanded one. Even VST users will gain from the advanced trigger capabilities of the TDW20. TD30 is a follow-up module of the TD20X. It has the same number of trigger inputs, more advanced positional sensing on every input, improved hi-hat, ride and snare triggering, the same number of audio outputs, and an analog slider for the ambience effect. The TD30 comes with the Roland Supernatural feature, and is still in production. The hi-hat triggering with VH12 and 13 is better, but not a significant reason to justify an upgrade from the TD20X. The instrument editing features and overall functionality is basically identical. The TD30 sounds are better, but due to the endless amount of instrument editing features, you are able to improve the TD20X module drum sounds a lot. A well-edited TD20X drum kit can sound better than a not well-edited TD30 drum kit. The TD30 is basically a modernized version of the TD20X. The TD30 basically kicked the TD20 from the throne in 2012 and became the standard for most professionals. Luke Oswald has it, the Rammstein drummer, and Neil Peart had one or still has it. You can connect it via USB port to your computer to trigger VSTs, while the TD20 requires a MIDI interface. You can plug in a USB flash drive, from which you can play MP3 files or save backups. The module is overall more up to date. The triggering in combination with a high-end VST, like Superior Geometry, is nearly identical with both TD20X and TD30. The TD30 costs $1,200 to $1,600 on the second-hand market, depending on its age and the condition. It costs around $2,000 new. If you prefer a modern module and you are concerned about the module sounds, you should rather pick the TD30. If you want a high-end VST trigger converter, you will be fine with a TD20X or TDW20. Mike Luke, for example, downgraded from a TD30 to a TD20X because he simply needs a plain MIDI trigger to control superior drummetry. The Roland TD25 is a cut-down version of the TD30. It is a very limited electronic drum module in many regards. First of all, it comes with a cable snake and no individual inputs. It does only have the following trigger inputs. It cannot be expanded with a slave module due to the missing MIDI input, and it has not many individual audio outputs, no analog volume sliders, and no trigger banks. It is not compatible with the VH12 and 13 due to the missing foot pressure feature, but only with the VH11. It has positional sensing on snare only, but overall, basically the trigger capabilities of the TD30s, and it has the supernatural feature too. The biggest flaw of the TD25 is that you cannot assign different instruments to the tom rims, for example. This does basically eliminate the use of a drum splitter, which will be explained later in the video. When people criticize Roland for becoming like Apple, they talk essentially about this drum module. It costs $1,000 new and around $600 used. This module is not really aimed towards the techie user, and actually more towards the practicing professional. It is basically an improved middle-class module. However, if you do not need many drum pads and you want to connect the module directly to a PC, you like modern controls, you like the TD30 drum sounds, and you want to have a clean and easy user interface, the TD25 is for you. If you want to trigger VSTs, be able to expand your drum set with endless pads, use a high-end hi-hat like the VH12 or 13, or the ATV hi-hat, you should go for the TDW20 or TD20X. Overall, the TD20 is a form of flagship module for professionals, with all kinds of pro features, while the TD25 is a current middle-class module and a reduced version of the TD30. Roland basically took away all geek features and made a simpler version of the former flagship. The Strike Pro costs around $1,000, so I find it a valid module for this comparison. The sounds of the Strike Pro are not only better, but play in an entire different league. It has many inputs, a USB port, SD card slot, color display, and many other nice functions. But it is not the best module in terms of triggering. The hi-hat and pad triggering in general is not very good. The module freezes and takes ages to load drum kits. If you want good sounds out of the box and aren't concerned about triggering issues and missing dynamics, get the Strike. However, I would not really recommend it to anyone, as I think it costs too much and too many people have issues with it. If you want a good sounding module, rather look into the 2-box Drummit 3, the ATV 85 or the Pearl Mimic, and potentially the new Geva drum module. As live drummer with lower budget and for professional VST recording, you should rather go for the TD20. At least you know that it will less likely fail. The 85 is compatible with any kind of pad on the market. It is much like the TD25 module, except it comes with real drum sounds. The higher triggering has much improved due to new updates. I tested it lately with the ATV hi-hat. Unfortunately, it has no positional sensing, but 3-zone ride compatibility. This module is very limited in terms of functions and features. You can't do much with it. No instrument editing features, and it cannot be expanded. The cable snake is a bit of a downside, but therefore the module is nice and small and comes at a certain quality. It is very well made, containing a bursted aluminium case. It feels very valuable. The 85 is aimed towards the plug and play guy, with a standard drum set, who wants to have a simple and easy to use module, and does not want to bother about settings and sound editing. It is not really made for VST triggering and MIDI e-drum recording. It is also not great for live gigs, as it lacks the audio outputs. In short, it is not really comparable with the TD20. I compared the two because the price is identical. Both TD20 and TD20X can be improved. Audio experts have created pre-customized sound bundles with great sounding drum sets. Find the links for my favorite sound bundles in the video description. Almost all of the TD20 trigger inputs are stereo, meaning even the toms have head and rim zone. These inputs can be split with a special cable called drum splitter. This way, you can connect two pads to one input. The TD20 lets you assign different instruments to head and rim, so you can change the tom rim sound to a cowbell or a side snare. The drum splitter is not working with the TD25. The TD20 and 12 have one common weak spot. Namely, the LCD screens show signs of wear after a few years. You can basically see stripes at the display. The replacement LCD is very hard to find these days. It cost about $100 when I saw it last time, and you need to open the module to fix it. I linked an instruction in the video description. TD12, 20 and 20X consist the exact same type of LCD screen. Please post a link in the comments if you know where to buy the replacement screen. Another less common issue is the backup battery. The battery dies after a while in some instances. The battery type can be found in the video description. Both repairs require a certain skill level and experience with electronics. The TD20 fits the standard Roland and Gibraltar module mounting plates. The screws in the bottom to hold the mount are 12mm M5 screws. TD20X and TDW20 users need a maximum 4GB compact flash card, and most likely a card reader to connect it to a PC. Else you might need cables and cable markers. Both are linked in the video description. A great safe place to buy this module is Drumtech's second-hand marketplace. The module costs a bit more, but you can be sure that you get an up-to-date, well-functioning unit from a trustworthy shop. eBay and Reverb are also good places to buy one, but check the seller ratings before. If you are a VST user and want a module with many inputs and dynamic triggering, especially in terms of hi-hat, snare and ride triggering, endless adjustment options for all kinds of settings, the TD20 is for you. The trigger capabilities of the TDW20/TD20X are in the trigger top 5, together with several newer flagship modules. That makes the module perfect for any professional VST recording attempt. The TD20X is also a valid option for any live e-drummer, with a limited budget for a module. The 8 audio outputs allow you to route separate instruments individually to the sound engineer's mixing desk, for him to be able to mix the drum set independently from the drummer. The sounds are good enough for small live shows, and even better with a pre-customized sound bundle. The TD20X is also a great stepping stone for anyone that saves up for a better module. If you do not want to buy an additional audio MIDI interface, but plug the module directly into your PC, you should rather get a modern module with an USB. In case you record with a VST like Easy Drummer 2 or Steven Slade Drums 4, positional sensing and advanced hi-hat triggering is not relevant, as the software would not recognize it anyway. So you can go for a cheaper module like the TD9. Everyone that wants great drum sounds integrated in a module should not buy any Roland sound module except the Roland TD50. If you want to have a great sounding electronic drum module without VSTs and computers, you should look into the ATV AD5, the Toolbox Drummit 3, or if the budget does allow it, the Pearl Mimic Pro. Many people see the TD20 as outdated, while in reality it is still an incredible powerful device that triggers much better than most Roland competitor modules. The VH11 and 12 in combination with the TDW20 and TD20X deliver a much better higher triggering result as most other modules on the market. Only the top 4 modules trigger better. The advanced trigger dynamic make the TDW20 and 20X one of the best modules in combination with a high-end VST like Superior Geometry, as the software recognizes positional sensing and generates an accurate hi-hat signal. Even big drummers like Travis Barker from Blink-182 use the TD20 for live shows. From a practical point of view, it is a great module with many great features. You get flagship triggering for a great price. That's it for the TD20 guide. I hope I could give you an overview of this module and help you to make a buying decision. If you want to support my efforts in making these videos, feel free to order your gear through my Amazon and Drumtech affiliate links. That's it, see you next time.